The most inferior of the muscle groups we're going to discuss are in the foot, and there are actually many muscles associated with the foot. There's actually going to be 20 muscles there, and almost all of them are going to be on the plantar or the sole portion of the foot. Now, I am going to discuss specific actions that can occur, but really they don't have as much importance as, say, you have in terms of the hand. If you think about manipulating things and flexing and extending the digits associated with your hand as opposed to your foot, you can understand that that's not quite as important. It's more important in terms of really being able to keep the foot, the joints associated with the foot, safe. And not only are the muscles going to play a role in terms of that, you're going to have specific connective tissues or aponeuroses playing a role. So the plantar aponeurosis, sometimes you hear this referred to as plantar fascia, this is going to play a really important role in terms of keeping those arches of the foot safe, as well as the specific joints. So you can see that right in this region. So basically, you can barely see any muscles until you reflect or move the plantar aponeurosis. So if you have any type of damage to this specific area, we often refer to this as plantar fasciitis, and this is a fairly common complaint in the foot region. Now, in this particular picture, you see that the plantar aponeurosis has been removed, and you're going to have the most superficial muscles on the plantar surface. You're going to have the abductor hallucis muscle, which you can see here. Anytime you have hallucis, you know you're talking first digit. So you can see abductor hallucis. Abduct means you're moving away from the midline, so think about moving that first digit even further, more medially. So kind of more medial, because remember, the first digit is going to be medial. Your flexor digitorum brevis muscle, which you can see right here. And you can see the tendons are extending to the digits, so allowing for flexion or curling in of the toes. And on the lateral side, you have the abductor digiti minimi, so moving that fifth digit away from the midline, which you can see right here. Now, as you move deeper, so in this particular image, those muscles we just discussed have been removed, we're getting into the lumbricals. And if you recall in previous discussions, we had lumbricals associated with the hand as well. And these are doing the exact same thing. You have the flexion of proximal phalanges and the extension of the middle and distal phalanges. And there's a mistake right here. This should say 2 through 5, so digits 2 through 5, not including the first digit. And similar to what we had in terms of the hand, these muscles actually have a proximal attachment on tendons, so specifically the flexor digitorum longus tendons. So these worm-like muscles are going from the flexor digitoris longus tendons to the actual digit regions. And then lastly, as you move deep, so the deepest layer in terms of the plantar surface muscles, you have interossei. So similar to what we had in the hand as well. And you're going to have those plantar interossei allowing for adduction, or moving back. And the dorsal interossei, which you can see in this picture here, allowing for abduction. Now, it's important to note, so recall we have those 5 digits associated with the foot. The first digit is going to be your great toe or your big toe. This is going to be the 5th digit. Now, in terms of the plane by which these muscles abduct or adduct, it's actually going to be this 2nd digit here. So when you have abduction, they're moving away from the 2nd digit. When you have adduction or adduction, they're moving back towards the 2nd digit. So slightly different than what you have in terms of the hand, which is going to be your 3rd digit. So that completes our discussion of the skeletal muscles of the body. We will return to some of these as we go into further portions of this series.